The Lake Nyos disaster took place on the 21st of August, 1986, in Menchum in the northwest region of Cameroon, where overnight the lake had experienced heavy rains prompting a landslide which had caused waters on the CO2-saturated lake to mix, causing a chain chemical reaction known as a Limnic eruption, in which the CO2 would rapidly escape the pool in a gaseous form. The cloud of gas, estimated at some 1.6 million tons of CO2, rose at nearly 100 kilometers per hour, and being that carbon is heavier than air, had immediately descended downwards and outwards, displacing the oxygen in the surrounding region for the next 25 kilometers surrounding the lake directly. It would remain close to the ground during its travel, like an invisible poison mist hugging the ground. The release was so vicious that the iron deposits on the floor of the lake had been pulled to the surface and oxidized, causing the lake to turn a deep red. The trees surrounding the shores of the lake had been completely knocked down. A large column of water being released caused a wave of some 25 meters high to sweep along the shore after the eruption. The disaster would claim the lives of 1,746 people, along with 3,500 livestock of the affected villages. Victims of the disaster would be examined to find that the cause of death would be CO2 asphyxiation, due to the rapid displacement of air with no sensory indication of change. Being that CO2 gives off no odor, most individuals would rapidly lose consciousness and fall, leading to only less oxygen being available, and ultimately death. The carbon dioxide that had escaped the lake lingered and flowed through the villages of Nyos, Shah, and Saboum, killing their inhabitants in their sleep. In the cases where individuals recognized the situation was occurring and fled, had soon developed respiratory issues, painful lesions, and in extreme cases, paralysis due to the exposure of a dangerous concentration of CO2. Any survivors would flee the doomed villages that lacked basic healthcare and would reach the city capital of Yaounde, where the main hospitals would be treating patients for what was believed to be poisoning by a mixture of gases. Due to the immense scale of such a disaster and the extreme loss of life, researchers had scrambled to immediately find out what had occurred, and worse, if it could happen again. It was found that the dangerous levels of CO2 could be somewhat maintained by using equipment to degas the lake gradually. With this, it was found that Lake Kivu in the DROTC, a lake nearly 2,000 times the size of Nyos, also had a supersaturation of CO2 in its waters. Not only that, it was found out that gassing events occur every 1,000 years.